Hi there, boys and girls. My name is Mr. Pete. I'm a fourth grade teacher, and I'm currently reading The Tale of Despero by Kate D. Camillo. We are about to start chapter 9, The Right Question. Don't know what the right question is. We shall find out. We left off with the Mouse Council voting to send Despero to the dungeon unless he renounces what he is being accused of, which is being seen in front of humans and kind of turning the world topsy-turvy. We know that Despero is on his way back because he left the king and the princess because the king hates him because he hates rodents for some reason. Something tells me we will find out why soon. Chapter 9, The Right Question. We were left with the question, what does perfidy mean? Hopefully you looked it up. Perfidy means deceitful, untrustworthy. And of course, Despero is dealing with an untrusting father, an untrusting family, and he is about to be dispatched to the dungeon unless he can defend himself. Let's see if he can do that. Chapter 9, The Right Question. To my class, make sure you have setting written at the top. Let's see where we head now. The Mouse Council sent Furlo to collect Despero, and Furlo found his brother in the library, standing on top of the great open book, his tail wrapped tightly around his feet, his small body shivering. Despero was reading the story out loud to himself. He was reading from the beginning so that he could get to the end, where the reader was assured that the knight and the fair maiden lived together happily ever after. Despero wanted to read those words, happily ever after. He needed to say them aloud. He needed some assurance, highlight vocabulary word. He needed to feel assured. He needed to feel like this could happen. He needed some assurance that this feeling he had for the Princess P, this love, would come to a good end. And so he was reading the story as if it were a spell, and the words of it spoken aloud could make magic happen. Simile, comparing the words of the story to a spell that would make it happen, make it be so. "See here," said Furlo out loud to himself. He looked at his brother and then looked away. "This is the kind of thing I am talking about. This is exactly the kind of thing. What's he doing here, for cripe's sakes? He's not eating the paper. He's talking to the paper. It's wrong, wrong, wrong." "Hey," he said to Despero. Despero kept reading. "Hey," shouted Furlo. "Despero, the Mouse Council wants you." "Pardon?" said Despero. He looked up from the book. "The Mouse Council has called you to sit with them." "Me?" said Despero.
"You."
"I'm busy now," said Despero, and he bent his head again to the open book. So he could care less. And how does this make it seem to Furlo? This important Mouse Council is beckoning him. Despero could care less. And Furlo is, well, you know how Furlo is. Furlo sighed. "Oh, jeez," he said. "Cripes, nothing makes sense to this guy. Nothing. I was right to turn him in. He's sick." Furlo crawled up the chair leg and then hopped onto the book. He sat next to Despero. He tapped him on the head twice. "Hey," he said, "the Mouse Council isn't asking, they're telling. They're commanding. You have to come with me right now." Despero turned to Furlo.
"Do you know what love is?" he said.
"Huh?"
"Oh, love."
Furlo shook his head.
"You're asking the wrong question," he said. "The question you should be asking is why the Mouse Council wants to see you."
"There is somebody who loves me," said Despero, "and I love her, and that is the only thing that matters to me."
"Somebody who loves you? Somebody who you love? What difference does that make? What matters is that you're in a lot of trouble with the Mouse Council."
Her name... Now, Despero's not paying any attention to this. They're having, like, two separate conversations. Furlo is like, "You're in trouble. Let's go see the council." And Despero's like, "Meh,
I'm in love."
"Her name?"
said Despero.
"His P."
"What?"
"The person who loves me. Her name is P."
Cripes, said Furlow. You're missing the whole point of everything here. You're missing the point of being a mouse. You're missing the point of being called to sit with the Mouse Council. You've got to come with me. It's the law. You've been called.
Despero sighed. He reached out and touched the words, Fair Maiden, in the book. He traced them with one paw, and then he put his paw to his mouth.
Cripes, said Furlow. You're making a fool of yourself. Let's go.
I honor you, whispered Despero. I honor you.
And then, reader, he followed Furlow over the book and down the chair leg and across the library floor to the waiting Mouse Council. He allowed his brother to lead him to his fate. Highlight that foreshadowing. Oh, Despero. Get yourself together, buddy. You're in trouble. Stop worrying about love right now. Uh-oh. The next chapter, Good Reasons, chapter 10. All right. You can see where Despero's head is. You can see where Furlow's head is. Furlow turned him in and wants to take him to the Mouse Council instead of being a good brother and helping him out. And Despero just wants to be in love. He did say something interesting. He said that P loves him and he loves her. Is that true? We don't know yet, or do we? We will find out later in this book, though, I promise you that. And let's not slow things down as we head to Despero seeing the Mouse Council. We're going to stop there and make sure you click that like button. Make sure you subscribe. Make sure you send me messages and leave comments and keep building our awesome community. We cannot do this without you. So I appreciate every single person who spends a minute with any of the books or any of the videos that we put together here. Thank you so much, and I will see you on the next La Page. That does not mean page in French. I just made that up. I don't know French. I keep slipping into all kinds of crazy accents. Such is life. See you on the next page. Peace.